So there are two forms of analysis that we're going to talk about today. This series is for technical analysis, but I think it's important to address what some of the differences are. So a fundamental analyst is going to approach the marketplace by trying to weigh all of the information in a given market, the earnings of a company, where interest rates are heading, the economic environment, both domestically and globally, what the competitors of the company are doing. And ultimately, the fundamental analyst is going to come up with a fair value, a price for where he or she thinks the stock should be trading. And if that stock is above that fair value, then it most likely should be sold because it's overvalued. But if the stock is trading below the analyst fair value price, then it's quote unquote undervalued and it should probably be bought. The technician is the opposite. The technician is going into a marketplace, assuming that all of the information that's out there that is known, and in many cases still unknown, is already priced into the price of the stock or the commodity or the exchange traded fund or the currency. So a technician has many advantages over the fundamental analyst. For number one, very simply, if you are an expert in a given industry, whether it be energy or technology or electricity, you're an expert in that industry. So as a fundamental analyst, it's very difficult to apply your area of expertise in, let's say, tech to a sector like energy or a sector like banks, right? The information and the area of expertise that you need to have is obviously very different. But as a technical analyst, we can apply our tools across the board. So this brings into account opportunity cost. So as a technician, we don't have to be an expert in energy or technology or banks or Latin America or Europe or Asia. We're applying our supply and demand principles that we're going to talk about here today across the board.